As a director, I'm involved in the whole process of this documentary. I began with coming up an idea, turning it into words, then shooting the scenes, and finally added the sources to get my final work. It was my first time to write a shooting script, my first time to challenge the highest temperature in summer with so many colleagues, and also my first time to do a location research and a field shooting. During the process, I experienced being a director, a leader, who can lead the team to turn an idea into a project. I'm glad that I have a strong team, and I really enjoy the cooperation with them. I enjoy doing the activities related to the communication field. When I was young, I took part in a filming program held by the television station. After I entered high school, I organized a flash mob by myself. Especially since 2 years, I'm crazy about taking photos. Thus, I am more interested in the visual mediums, just like the films and the photos. To practice myself, I decided to become a director during the summer holiday. And this can also help me determine whether it is suitable for me to choose communication as a major in the future university. Since its content and main idea are more suitable for a documentary, at last I made a documentary. Bridges are very special to me. When I was in grade 9, I rode to school by myself. At that time, I was very afraid of bridges because it really cost me a lot of energy. Thus, I wanted to escape from them. However, some of my friends, they wanted to play fun on me, so they brought me to some high-end steel bridges to have fun. Gradually, I'm used to climbing the bridges, and I finally love the feeling of crashing down the bridges. The reason why I choose Qingming Bridge is because it is near to my home, and I almost pass it every day. Hence, it gradually becomes a part of my memories. Moreover, Qingming Bridge is a very important place in Wuxi. It was an accident for me to choose Yanjia Bridge. Once I was on my way back to my grandma's home, Changshu, and I passed by Yanjia Bridge. Immediately, I was shocked by its terrible and desolate state. When I was back home, I searched some information about Yanjia Bridge, and it was a surprise for me to find that it is a place that has rich historical background. In order to make more people know Yanjia Bridge, I chose to include it in my documentary. For me, bridge is a representation of Jiangnan culture, a purveyor of memory. I'm very proud that we have unique Chinese culture, so I chose the topic of cultural inheritance in order to let more people know that we have our own culture. And moreover, I want to call on them to protect our culture. Regarding to how to protect the culture, I have already mentioned two ways of different cultural inheritance in my documentary.
The Grand Canal flows from ancient to present, and the Ningxuan Temple bell rings from winter to autumn. The Grand Canal runs through Wuxi from Beijing to Hangzhou, lapping the banks gently for thousands of years. Qingming Bridge Block, a unique South China historical and cultural area, is situated to the south of Ningxuan Temple. The bridge was originally donated to the city by two brothers, Tai Qing and Tai Ning. Hence, it was originally named Qingning after the brothers. During Qing Dynasty, The bridge was renamed Qingming Bridge in order to avoid using the name of the Daoguang Emperor Min Ning, as using the emperor's name was taboo in Imperial China. Over hundreds of years, billions of people have walked across the bridge, leaving traces of their own. Mrs. Yu, a local resident who has lived here for more than 60 years, told us the story of her memories of the bridge. Qingming Bridge Block's role in the community has changed as the society has developed over the years. Thanks to its location at the heart of the city and its commercial elements, the block has gradually become a fantastic place for people to relax and have fun. The monument of rich history and culture has been slowly infused with modern flavor. The history of Qingming Bridge is now hidden deeply in the memories in the old people's mind. The city's booming tourist industry and thriving economy have superseded the old model. Different neighborhoods preserve culture in different ways. Qingming Bridge Block, which chose to integrate modern elements, has now reached its peak. However, another cultural block, Yanjia Bridge Block, chose to preserve its historic appearance. It has successfully retained the look and feel of ancient China, rather than being imprinted by the traces of modern life. Yanjia Bridge was built during the Ming Dynasty, and it was originally a stone bridge. It was built by Yan Heyong, a descendant of the legendary Eastern Han Dynasty intellectual Yan Zilin. Yanjia Bridge has a long history. More than 3,000 years ago, during Shang and Zhou dynasties, our ancestors reclaimed land, built canals, planted grain, and lived here for generations. Yanjia Bridge is located at the junction of Wuxi, Jiangyin, and Changshu. With this rich cultural integration, it becomes the first historical and cultural village of Jiangsu province in Wuxi. This region is the cradle of Wuxi opera. Yuan Renyi, an early practitioner of Wuxi opera who lived in Yanjia Bridge, made a huge contribution to popularizing this art across China. Since then, Wuxi opera has been passed down from one generation to another, like a fire that never burns out. As one of the birthplaces of Chinese industry and commerce, the region has shone like a bright pearl through history, but now it chooses to show the world its most natural face. Countless people have grown up here, witnessing the inheritance of the ancient culture. Huang Kai, a young man, spent his whole childhood in this place. To him, Yanjia Bridge is his eternal homeland.
小时候，人家桥赞美没有政府整改前的话，它原来没有这么大，也很古朴。就一句话，古朴。现在你们浏览到看到的样子，其实是政府翻新过的。这边戏剧很出名，我们小学还有一个比赛呢。戏剧的话，作为这边的一个文化特征的话，我觉得是应该一个很重要的一个元素，因为它在这里传播的比较广吧，几乎上是每个人都会唱。 每个人都知道这个戏是演的什么意思。我在这边从小感觉到的内涵还是基本保留的，因为这边的生活情趣吧就比较不是特别的像年轻人那样轻快，这边比较缓，也比较休闲。然后这边文化保留的话，我觉得算比较完整嘛，因为它这边的建筑啊、戏剧啊、环境啊都比较保留，只有这边的一个算是一个小公园吧，是被自己扩建的，它并没有做太大的 破坏，然后基本上是在原有的基础上扩建了的。我觉得戏剧在对于这边来说是一种文化的保留，因为它这边戏剧的一个发源地嘛。这边所有的一切，它的政府并没有做太大的那个商业的规划，而是在古镇原有的建筑啊、文化，还有民众的一些生活习惯嘛，只是做了稍微的一些拓展。我觉得年轻人适合清明桥，而老年人的安
Although far from the urban life, the villagers in Yanjia Bridge still enjoy this original lifestyle, looking for their simplest happiness. It's a miraculous paradise, protecting its unique charm quietly in its own way, while waiting for the world to discover it. Inheritance is a profound word. However, it does not necessarily require a rigid meaning. It can be a change, spreading culture in a popular way. It can be preservation, showing people the original appearance of culture. The traditional culture is getting farther and farther away from our life. The only thing that can stop it from walking away forever might be the inheritance from one generation to the next.